Hey Leute, willkommen zurück zu Let's Play The Great Ace Attorney Chronicles. Im letzten Part haben wir China noch immer nicht so richtig davon überzeugen können, dass wir sie verteidigen sollen. Und gerade als sie uns jetzt wieder zurückschicken will, können wir uns mal ihre Ärmel etwas genauer angucken. Und ich frage mich, was das ist. Sind Red Stains, also rot sind die. Sind für mich zwar eigentlich nicht wirklich rot, ehrlich gesagt, diese Flecken, aber ist anscheinend Blut. So viel Blut hier. Wem gehört das und wie kam das dahin? Ach, some very suspicious Red Stains. What? Why are you looking at me like that? I think it might be worth presenting some of our other findings in that area to China now. Okay, ich muss ihr noch mehr präsentieren. Ja, mach ich mal. Wahrscheinlich, genau, hier unsere Blutspuren, die wir bisher schon gefunden haben. Weil ich meine, es ist auf dem Mantel drauf, der ursprünglich McGilde gehört hat, also ist es wahrscheinlich auch das Blut von Mason, denke ich mal. Wir könnten ja eine Blutprobe machen und gucken, ob das dann auch lila wird. Ja. Also Moment, erst presenten, sorry, present. So, ja. Those stains on the sleeves of your new coat, China. They're blood, aren't they? Not that I know whose blood yet.
What? Blood, Mr. Naruhodo?
You don't appear to have any obvious wounds yourself, though. So could it be blood that spattered from Mr. Windybank when he was shot last night?
Let's not beat around the bush here. This trusty friend of mine will get results much, much faster than anything else. Ey, take it easy, Iris.
Du hast uns doch auch schon die ganze Zeit abgeschossen.
Don't move, Ginny. I'm going to shoot.
Aha. Boah, holy, holy. Überall sogar. Eieiei.
Oh. Oh, oh my.
What the? Forget the sleeves.
The whole coat is covered in blood.
Of course. The black color of the fabric was masking the stains. That's why we haven't seen them until now. Ja. Wie sie jetzt aussieht. Als hätte jemand einen Farbeimer über sie gekippt. Ja, und das macht natürlich McGilded nur noch verdächtiger, wenn auf seinem Mantel so viel Blut drauf ist. Wie ist es da wohl hingekommen? Doch nicht etwa da, als er zufällig jemanden ermordet hat, oder?
And the blood has reacted with the chemical to turn a purple color, which matches one of the samples we've already collected perfectly. Yes, now let's see. Who had the purple blood? Aha, yes, it was the brickmaker Mr. Mason, the victim of the murder case 2 months ago.
Knew it.
What? What are you all on about? The victim? What do you mean? It's a rather uncomfortable situation, Mr. Naruhodo, but I think this makes things quite clear. It means the omnibus case is finally solved. The truth about who really murdered the brickmaker, Mr. Mason, is revealed. Oi, would someone explain what's going on? Stop telling half a story.
Hä? Dürfen wir jetzt nicht ihr das erzählen? Oder wie? Warum reden wir jetzt mit Susato? Na, die Wahrheit auf jeden Fall von dem Omnibus-Fall. We can see now that the victim's blood is all over Mr. McGilded's overcoat.
But in the trial 2 months ago, the defendant said this is this in his testimony.
Now I ask you, what good-hearted soul wouldn't rush to help a fella bleeding from his stomach? I wasn't about to start worrying about meat gloves now, was I? I reached out to give the man a hand. But if you look at this overcoat now, it's clear. These stains couldn't have arisen from McGilded trying to pull the victim to his feet.
No, if that was what really had happened, the blood wouldn't have splashed all over the front of the coat.
The only explanation for this pattern of blood is that it splattered over McGilded's coat when he stabbed the victim in the stomach. Mm-hmm. I've tried to run from the truth for long enough, but there's no escaping it now. The true culprit in that case, Mr. Mason's killer, was Magnus McGilded.
Mr. Naruhodo.
That horrible case is solved at last.
And I helped the man walk free from the trial. I used all the twisted testimony and all the sham evidence to prove his innocence. How could I have let it happen? Bruno, did you believe him though? Did you believe Mr. McGill was innocent? I believed. Or rather, I think I was trying to believe. I wanted to. Because believing in those you represent in court is a defense lawyer's greatest weapon. A weapon? Die Waffe eines Anwalts! Before we came to Great Britain, a great friend of mine taught me a valuable lesson.
You mean Kazuma's hammer?
Listen, Ryunosuke. We lawyers are only human. We can't know for sure what is the truth and what is a lie. Which is why we must resort to our primary weapon. An unwavering belief in our clients. That's all we really have.
Unwavering belief?
Only when we truly believe what our clients tell us can we fight with everything we have for their cause. In any battle, there can be no victory without faith. So I believe you. Unwaveringly.
What's funny, China?
Oh, sounds like in this empire of Japan you come from, everyone must be soft. Well, come on. Look at the mess it's got you into, believing in that bogtrotter.
Yes, I inadvertently helped a murderer walk free.
Well, at least you've learned your lesson now, eh? Believing in people is never worth it. Someone always steps you in the back in the end. Soon as you let down your guard, you've added. Take a leaf out of my book. Believe no one. Get hurt by no one.
Weiß ich nicht.
China, may I ask you something? What? I'd just like to make absolutely sure. What would you like us to do with these representation papers for tomorrow's trial? How many times do I have to say it? Rip him up and chuck him away. Are you really sure that's what you want?
Komm schon, China.
I bet that's what he wants and all now, Mr. I'm a believer lawyer over there. Don't forget it was me in that trial 2 months ago. I let everyone up the garden path, didn't I? And you're telling me you can believe in me after that? Not likely. Well, Mr. Naruhodo.
A lawyer's primary weapon is an unwavering belief in his clients. Ultimately, it comes down to whether or not I feel I can trust China after everything that's happened. Nach allem, was passiert ist, können wir da... Ja, eigentlich steht's da anders. Im Endeffekt kommt's darauf an, ob ich eben China noch vertrauen kann nach allem, was passiert ist. Können wir ihr vertrauen oder nicht? Natürlich können wir das. Ich meine, sie hat den Mord ja auch nicht begangen. Und vielleicht hat sie ein paar andere Male auch noch gelogen. Das mag ja sein. Aber grundsätzlich hat sie ein gutes Herz, da bin ich mir sicher. Und deswegen, ich vertraue ihr. Und jetzt hat sie ja wirklich die ganze Wahrheit gesprochen und aus vollem Herzen gesprochen. Und deswegen, ja. China, let me say it again. Please allow me to represent you in tomorrow's trial.
Hey, are you half-baked?
Not at all. You've not once admitted to committing the crime, have you? What's more, I believe that you're telling me the truth.
Seriously, Mr. Narrow Odo?
wunderschön.
Didn't you hear all of what I said before? I'm a born liar. Phipps just tripped me off tongue. Trip off me tongue. And I'm a diver, don't forget. I pulled the wool over your eyes 2 months ago and got you into all sorts of trouble. Why would you ever trust me now? I just don't get it. China. I do understand why you choose not to put your trust in others. But I assure you, there's more to this life than you yet realize. What do you mean? The world we live in,
is full of people you would do very well to trust. People who won't ever let you down.
Eh? It's true that I'm just a student of law, and I'm certainly lacking in courtroom experience. But I can promise you this. Whatever happens, and until my very last breath, I am completely on your side.
What? What do you expect me to say to that?
Oh, Gina! Natürlich will sie es nicht zeigen, wie sie heult.
Then it's decided. I will take these papers now and carry out the necessary preparations for tomorrow's trial. It would be a shame to throw them away now after it's been penned with your name so beautifully.
Do what you like. You Eastern lot are...
I don't know what you are. I don't get ya.
Yay!
Gina's taken herself off to the back of her cell. She'd never admitted, but I hope she's feeling relieved. That turned out all right in the end, I think.
Ja, bei Shows muss man auch noch vorbeigucken. Oder? Kommt nochmal Fortsetzung folgt? Nee.
Whoever's hiding there! Show yourself at once! Eavesdropping is the height of coward dice!
Oder so. Mr. Sato?
Somebody is there in the shadows. I can sense it. Somebody who wasn't there before.
What? Blimey, you're sharp, eh? Ah, okay. I suppose you were using one of those mystic Japanese arts, like the art of stealth I've heard so much about. If anyone was being stealthy, it was you, Inspector.
Grexy!
Oh, dear me! I'm most terribly sorry, your ladyship. I didn't mean to startle you.
How long have you been listening in on our conversation?
Good grief! Listening in? No, no, no! I just got word that there were some visitors who were refusing to leave even though it was after hours. I assure you, your ladyship, I only just arrived. This very minute, not a moment earlier.
That's all it is, nothing untoward, nothing at all!
After hours? Is it that late already? So then, I'll humbly excuse myself now, your ladyship. Ta-ta, toodaloo, cheerio, all the best, bye, bye and bye! That's a lot of farewells, and not one of them appropriate for her ladyship.
Oh, but I wanted to have a chat.
I'm terribly sorry, but time is present at the minute.
Oh, I see. That's a shame.
If I don't get this emergency at the Supreme Court dealt with sharpish, Lord Strongheart will, well...
Emergency?
Lord Strongheart? Nothing! Forget I said anything! Anyway, I'm off.
Alright, Grexy, if you have to. But let's chat soon.
Delighted, charmed, can't wait. If you please, my pleasure! That's a lot of pleasantries or so, and not one of them sounded sincere.
Grexy's so funny, he says such silly things.
It's certainly entertaining to see an inspector of the police fawning to a 10-year-old girl. But anyway, I wonder what this emergency is at the Supreme Court.
I must attend the court clerk's office now before it closes.
Yes, of course. Thank you, Mr. Sato.
Kindly escort Iris home now, Mr. Naruhodo. I shall meet you there later.
Ja, Shoms doch noch. Oder nicht? Ich will bei Shoms noch vorbeigucken. And so our investigation came to an end. Wirklich? So Sato-san went to file the necessary papers for my defense of Gina the following day. And then it hit me. I could no longer suppress the wretched feeling that had been gnawing away at my insides. Tomorrow, Susato-san would be leaving. Leaving Britain and making her way back to Japan. Ja, vielleicht können wir das doch noch irgendwie verhindern. Weil doch auch noch irgendwie Strongheart in den Fall verwickelt ist und das gefällt mir ja nicht so wirklich, was Strongheart da gesagt hat. Ich meine, es ist ja auch so, dass das Gregson oder ganz Scotland Yard ja noch im Hintergrund an irgendeinem anderen riesigen Fall arbeitet, wo eben auch irgendwie Strongheart damit was zu tun hat oder so. Vielleicht können wir den nebenbei auch noch gleich lösen oder so. Ich weiß es nicht. Mal gucken.
Naruhodo-san, it's been a very trying day, hasn't it? I do hope you're not too exhausted.
What about you, Sato-san? Today has been even more trying for you, I'm sure. Mr. Sholmes was shot before our eyes. Sheena was arrested. All on the back of the news that her father has fallen ill and that she must return to Japan at once. I hope your father recovers soon.
Thank you for your kind words. I wonder why it is that so many thoughts rage in my head like a storm. And yet, I seem unable to find the words to express any of them.
I know exactly what you mean.
Anyway, I have one final task to complete as your judicial assistant. Once that is done, I shall make preparations for my departure tomorrow.
One final task. Okay. Wie genau ist es dann? Ist sie dann morgen auch im Gericht quasi nicht mehr dabei? Sie hat nicht genau gesagt, wann sie morgen abfahren muss. Also sie muss ja auch noch Vorbereitungen treffen, hat sie gesagt. Also ist sie echt nicht im Gericht dabei, oder wie? Das geht ja gar nicht. So, wir können dann eben... Oh Gott, über noch einiges reden. Aber ja, ich würde erstmal sagen, dass das hier war für diesen Part von Let's Play The Great Ace Attorney Chronicles. Beim nächsten Mal reden wir doch dann mit Susato ein bisschen. Aber bald ist dann anscheinend dieser Ermittlungstag hier vorbei. Der hat auch wirklich sehr lange gedauert. War, glaube ich, einer der längsten Ermittlungstage in ganz Ace Attorney. Und dann wird die Gerichtsverhandlung losgehen. Aber es ist ja immer noch der erste Tag quasi. Ich denke mal, dass es schon hier zwei Tage geben wird. Also der letzte Fall ist ja ewig lang. Bin ich mal sehr gespannt, vor allem dann ohne Susato eben. Aber vielleicht können wir es doch noch irgendwie schaffen, dass sie doch dabei ist und dass sie hier bleibt. Das wäre am besten... Wir reden dann beim nächsten Mal mit ihr und gucken mal, ob sich da vielleicht irgendwas machen lässt. Okay, also dann Leute, bis zum nächsten Mal.